due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the world stops. But not that the determination of others to be a registered profession. Welcome to our online meeting.
Hi! Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So, sa lahat po ng mga nag-subscribe sa aking channel, maraming salamat po. At sa mga hindi pa po nakakapag-subscribe, paki-subscribe na lamang po ako. And paki-click na rin po ang ating bell button for more updates. So, ang pag-usapan po natin sa ngayon ay ang ating nursing ethics and jurisprudence, kung saan ito po ay laging lumalabas sa mga lahat ng NPs or mga nursing practice sa inyong nursing board exam. So, let's begin with our question number 1. Situation: the goal of ethical reasoning in the context of nursing is to reach a mutual peaceful agreement that is in the best interest of the client. Reaching an agreement may require compromise. Question number 1. When ethical issue arises, which of the following is the most important nursing responsibility? A. Ensure that a team is responsible for deciding ethical questions. B. Remain natural and detached when making ethical questions. C. Be able to defend the morality of one's own actions. Or option D. Follow the client and a family wishes exactly. So, when ethical issue arises, which of the following options is the most important nursing responsibility? Okay, so punta tayo sa ating option letter B. Remain natural and detached when making ethical decision. So, take note, nurses, the nurse may have strong personal beliefs but distancing oneself from the situation does not serve the client. So, mali po ang ating option letter B. So, the next, sa option letter A naman natin, ensure that a team is responsible for deciding ethical question. Take note that a team is not always required to reach decisions. So, mali din yung ating letter A kasi a team is not always required to reach decisions. So, sa letter D naman natin, follow the client and a family wishes exactly. Mali din po yun kasi take note that nurse is not obligated to follow the client's wishes automatically when they may have negative consequences for self or others. So, hindi lahat ng gusto ng patient natin is pinapollow po natin. So, titingnan natin kung ang consequence nito ay negative para sa kanya or para sa iba. So, option D is also eliminated. So, the correct answer here in your question number 1 is letter C. A nurse's action in an ethical dilemma must be defensible according to moral and ethical standards. So, letter C is the best answer here. The next question number 2. Which of the following is a clear violation of the underlying principles associated with professional nursing ethics? A. A healthcare facility policy that permits the use of internal fetal monitoring, which in the literature evidence points to either support or refuse this practice. Letter B. The nurses on the unit agree to sponsor a fundraising event to support a labor strike proposed by fellow nurses at another healthcare facility. C. A client report that he didn't quite tell the doctor the truth when asked if he was following his therapeutic diet at home. Or letter D. When asked about the purpose of a medication, a nurse colleague responds, "Oh, I never look them up. I just give them what is prescribed." So, among which of the following is a clear violation of the underlying principles associated with professional nursing ethics? So, is it option A, B, C, or D? So, sa option A natin, a healthcare facility policy permits the use of internal fetal monitoring, which in the literature evidence points to either support or refuse the practice. So, sa ating option letter A, that is not a violation in the principles of the professional nursing ethics. So, hindi po siya violation kasi nga evidence-based naman po pala yung ating paggamit ng ating fetal monitor. So, letter B, the nurse on the unit agree to sponsor a fundraising event to support a labor strike. So, sa ating option letter B, although some may view that nurses' strike is unethical, supporting others who are striking is a personal decision of the nurse. So, pwede pa rin po yun, okay? So, letter C, a client report that he didn't quite tell the doctor the truth when asked if he has following the therapeutic diet at home. So, although a client in confidence to a nurse may have ethical overtones, It does not automatically constitute an ethical dilemma. Since the assigned physician or healthcare provider is a member of the team, principles of confidentiality do not include him or her. So option C is still correct. So the correct answer here is letter D. Okay, letter D is associated with the violation of the professional nursing ethics because the nurse has an ethical responsibility to act only when actions are safe or risk is minimized. So this nurse is putting the client at unnecessary risk for medication error. So many medical practices are controversial but not necessarily unethical. So letter D is the correct answer here. The next question, number 3, which of the following statements would be most helpful when a nurse is assisting clients in clarifying their values? A. The most important thing is to follow the plan of care. Did you follow the doctor's order? B. Some people might have a different decision. What led you to make your decision? C. If you had asked me, I would have given you my opinion. Now, how do you feel about your choice? Or letter D, that was not a good decision. Why did you think it would work? So, among which of the following statements would be most helpful for the patient for clarifying their values? Okay, so here in your option A, B, C, or D, the correct answer here is letter B. So, take note that in values clarification, clients are assisted to think about the factors that influence their beliefs and decisions. So, yung A, C, and D, they are judgmental statement and that reflects the rightness or the wrongness of the client's thoughts or actions will impede the process of clarifying their values. So A, B, and C are incorrect and letter D is the best statement here to help the client to clarify their values. That was not a good decision. Why did you think it would work? The next question, number 4. A dying patient asked for overdosage of pills from the nurse to end his life for his unbearable pain caused by cancer. If the nurse grants the patient request, she is liable for A. active euthanasia, B. negligence, C. advanced directive, or letter D. assisted suicide. So among which of the following is the liability of the nurse who gave an overdosage of pills after the patient asked for it? Okay, so alin po dito yung ginawa ni nurse? A. active euthanasia, negligence, advanced directive, or assisted suicide. Okay, so among the following options or choices here, una po nating i-eliminate si negligence. Kasi if we say negligence, negligence is simply the kapabayaan or carelessness. Kasi if we define negligence, negligence is defined as the failure to exercise the standard of care that a reasonably prudent person would have exercised in a similar situation. Or that is the unintentional commission or omission of an act that reasonably prudent person would or would not do under the same or similar circumstances. Okay, so that is heedlessness. That is caused by heedlessness. Okay, so that is negligence. So eliminated po ang ating negligence. So letter A, active euthanasia. So active euthanasia po ba yan or yung ating assisted suicide? So ano po bang pagkakaiba ng ating active euthanasia at saka assisted suicide? So dito sa ating active euthanasia, si nurse mismo ang magbibigay ng overdose drug. Okay, yan, yung si nurse ang mag-i-inject ng fatal dose ng drug na ikakamatay ng ating patient. That is the active euthanasia. So pag sinabi naman kasi nating passive euthanasia, yung isa, yung passive euthanasia, that is the intentionally letting a patient die by withholding artificial life support such as the ventilator or feeding tube. Yun naman yung tatanggalin mo ng kanyang mechanical ventilator o yung kanyang tubo para hindi na siya makahinga. That is the passive euthanasia. Again, sa active euthanasia, nag-i-inject ka ng fatal dose of drug. So, nag-i-inject ka. So, sa assisted suicide kasi, as per request ng patient po kasi yun. Okay? So, pag ni-request ng patient, gusto na niya matapos ang buhay niya, kaya gusto niya mag-suicide. So, pag ikaw ang nag-supply ng gamot na yun, binigyan mo siya ng kanyang request, ibinigay mo yung gamot na nire-request niya, yung overdosage ng pills na yan. So, that is assisted suicide. Kasi ang pagkakaiba po niya kaya active euthanasia. Kay active euthanasia kasi, si nurse mismo ang mag-i-inject ng gamot. Pero dito sa ating assisted suicide, si nurse lang or yung doctor lang magbibigay ng gamot, pero si patient pa rin ang magte-take ng gamot. So example sa ating situation, that is your overdosage of pills. So pag sinabi po kasi nating pills, pills is orally taken. So ngayon, pag inabot na ni nurse yung pills na yon, na kay patient pa rin yon kung ite-take niya yung pills or hindi. So pag tinake ni patient yung pills, si patient ang nag-cause ng death din niya sa sarili niya. So siya ay nagpakamatay by means of the pills na binigay ni nurse. So assisted suicide ang ginawa ni nurse kasi pinagbigyan niya yung request ni patient. Okay? Pero pag ito ay naman injection, mismong si nurse na nag-inject ng gamot at yun ang nag-cause ng death ng patient, that is the active euthanasia. So in contrast naman sa ating passive euthanasia, pag sinabi naman natin passive euthanasia, that is the intentionally letting patient die by withholding the artificial life support such as the ventilator, feeding tube na siyang magkukos ng has and death of the patient. So, yun po yung ating passive euthanasia. So, tinanggalan mo siya ng tubo kaya hindi na siya nakahinga or tinigil mo na yung pagtitake niya ng feeding tube o yung pagkain. So, hindi na siya nakakain kaya doon siya nang hina at namatay na yung patient. So, passive euthanasia po yun. So, the correct answer here is letter D. That is an example of assisted suicide because if we say assisted suicide, that is providing another person the means to end his or her own life. Okay? So, pag sinabi po natin assisted suicide, the nurse provides the means but the final act is in the patient. So, letter D is the correct answer here. The next question, number 5. The midwife is verbally accusing the nurse that the latter caused the medication errors without citing an evidence. The midwife can be sued for A. Assault, B. Slander, C. Defamation, or D. Libel. Okay, si midwife daw inaakusuhan yung nurse na nag-cause ng medication error, okay? Pero wala po siyang ebidensya. So ano pong pwede nating isampa kay midwife? A. Assault, slander, defamation, or libel. So, una nating tatanggalin dito si letter A, assault, kasi wala naman pong pagbabantang naganap dito. Kasi if we say assault occurs when a person puts another person in fear of a harmful or an offensive contact. So, assault means to threaten a person. So, pagbabanta, pag sinabi natin assault. So, wala naman pagbabantang naganap, so tanggal yung ating letter A. Then next, letter C, defamation. So, pag sinabi naman natin defamation is defined as a false communication or a careless disregard for the truth that causes damage to someone's reputation. So, either in writing or verbal po yan. So, pag sinabi natin defamation, we have your three types of defamation. We have your slander by deeds, and we have your libel. Okay. So, pag sinabi po natin libel is your defamatory act by means of writing. Okay? Writing or any printed materials or any distributive forms. So, lahat ng pwedeng i-distribute like your audio, video, written form, printed form, that is libel. It constitute libel. So, pag ito ay in-upload sa internet or sa mga social media sites, that is your cyber libel. Okay? Pero pag sinabi naman natin orally spoken po siya, okay? Orally spoken or verbally po siya, slander po yung ginawa mong defamation or defamatory act. So, take note that defamation is a crime against honor. Okay? A crime against honor. So, defamation is a false communication disregarding the truth that causes damage to someone's reputation. Nakakasira po ng puri. Okay? Nakakasira ng puri. That is your defamation. So, pag sinabi natin slander is verbally po yun. So, the correct answer here is letter B. So, spoken comment or verbally or orally stated is slander that causes a person's ridicule or contempt or damage their reputations constitutes. So, letter B is the correct answer here. So, ang keyword natin dyan, slander is lang. Masyadong may slang kaso, oral po yun. So, slander is oral defamation. So, pag sinabi naman natin libel is writing in form. So, libel, lapis at papel. Okay, lapis at papel, libel, that is in written form or any printed materials that discredits a person or destroys someone's reputation. So, the correct answer here is slander. So, letter B is the correct answer. The next question, number 6. You are a staff nurse in the neurology unit of the hospital. You failed to report to duty due to Typhoon Yolanda that hit your place, causing massive destruction. Whatever sentinel event that may happen at the time of your absence, you may be exonerated from any liability under the legal doctrine of A. Captain of the ship, B. Force majeure, C. Justice, or D. Respect for person. So, hindi ka daw naka-attend ng duty mo kasi kayo po ay binagyo. Okay? So, nagkaroon kayo ng massive destruction caused by your Typhoon Yolanda. So, whatever sentinel event may happen at the time of your absence, you may be exonerated from any liability under the legal doctrine of... So, una nating tatanggalin dito yung letter A natin. So, captain of the ship is eliminated here. Why? Kasi pag sinabi po natin captain of the ship doctrine is the legal doctrine
which holds that during an operation in an operating room, a surgeon of record is liable for all actions conducted in the course of the operation. So example po, nagkaroon ng pagkakamali sa ating sponge counting or sa ating sponge count. So nagkaroon ng retention ng sponge sa loob ng abdomen ng patient. So liable dun yung doctor, yung surgeon natin, kasi siya po ay may control sa mga tauhan or mga sa ating operating room team members sa kanilang maginagawa. So in control yung surgeon doon. So captain of the ship ang tawag natin doon. So for letter C, justice is one of the bioethical principle, which means to provide an equal and fair treatment for your patient. So hindi po yan ating hinahanap. So letter D naman, respect for person is one of the fundamental principles in research, with it is the recognition of a person as autonomous, unique and free individual. So it also means that we recognize that each person has the right and capacity to make her or his own decision. So respecting a person ensures that dignity is valued. So hindi rin po yan yung ating sagot. So the correct answer here is your force majeure. So keyword in your question number 6, you may be exonerated from any liability. So ano po bang ibig sabihin ng exonerated? So pag sinabi mong exonerated, na absolved ka sa isang liability. So napawalang sala ka doon or out ka na sa isang situation or sentinel event. So kapag ikaw exonerated, wala ka nang magiging kasalanan kasi absuelto ka. So that is under the force majeure doctrine. So letter B is the correct answer. Kasi pag sinabi po natin force majeure, these are the unanticipated events such as natural disasters that is beyond the control of the parties and makes fulfillment of contractual obligation impossible. So ito po yung ating mga unforeseen, irresistible, and inevitable events like your natural disasters. Pag nagkaroon ng typhoon, fire, ano pa, tsunami, ano pa, earthquake. So yun po yung mga yun, riots, wars. So these are all examples of your force majeure events. So kapag may nangyaring ganun at nagkaroon ng problema sa ospital at hindi ka nakapunta sa duty mo, that is an example of your doctrine of force majeure, okay? So the presence of force majeure event will exempt you from liability. So it creates exemption from liabilities and it allocates the risk of loss in certain circumstances. The next question, number 7. Tessie is an RN, was invited as a resource person in a nursing conference. The curriculum vitae she submitted to the PRC Continuing Professional Development Council reflects the word Masters of Arts in Nursing or MAN after her name. She only completed academic requirements but not her thesis writing. Which of the following did Tessie violate? A. RA 9173 or Nursing Law, B. Code of Professional Ethics for Teachers, C. Magna Carta for Health Workers, or D. Code of Ethics for Registered Nurses. So in this situation, si Tessie ay isa ng registered nurse, okay? Nag-master's degree siya, kaso nga lang hindi niya natapos ang kanyang thesis, which is one of the requirement bago ka ikaw ay mag-conferred as a man or Masters in Arts in Nursing. So she only completed academic requirements but not her thesis writing daw. So which of the following did Tessie violate? So nasa RA 9173 po ba yan? Sa Code of Professional Ethics for Teachers, Magna Carta for Health Workers, or nasa Code of Ethics for Registered Nurse po yan, okay? So take note in your question number 7, the correct answer here is letter A, RA 9173. So RA 9173 specifically under the Article 8, Section 35 of your Republic Act 9173, any person practicing nursing in the Philippines within the meaning of your RA 9173 who attains BSN or RN or Bachelor of Science in Nursing or Registered Nurse or any similar appendage to his or her name without having been conferred to said degree or registration shall be guilty of misdemeanor or fraudulent misrepresentation. So tandaan po natin yan, kapag tayo daw naglalagay ng title after our names na hindi naman tayo officially conferred to it, like your MAN, naglagay ka ng RN pero hindi ka pa naman nakakapasa sa board exam, that is an example of your fraudulent misrepresentation or misdemeanor case. So the correct answer here is letter A, that is under the Article 8, Section 35 of RA 9173. The next question, number 8, which of the following regulates the practice of the nursing profession? A. Department of Health, B. Professional Regulation Commission, C. Civil Service Commission, or D. Professional Regulatory Board of Nursing. So take note, keyword here, it regulates the practice of the nursing profession. So the correct answer here, nurses, is letter D, Professional Regulatory Board of Nursing. So sila po ang nagre-regulate ng practice ng nursing profession. So letter B, Professional Regulation Commission regulates the different regulatory boards. Example, lahat po yan, the 42 regulatory boards including the Board of Nursing is regulated by the Professional Regulation Commission. And the professionals or the professional nurses are regulated by its regulatory board known as the Board of Nursing. So the correct answer here is letter D, Professional Regulatory Board of Nursing. Alright, the next question, number 9. A registered nurse has had her license suspended after being convicted of being impaired at work. What governing body has the authority to revoke or suspend a nurse's license? A. Professional Regulatory Board of Nursing, B. Professional Regulatory Commission, C. Supreme Court, or D. Ombudsman. Okay, so sino daw ang merong authority to revoke or suspend a nurse's license? So, Supreme Court, tanggal na po yan, and lalong-lalo na po yung ating ombudsman, so wala po dyan yung ating tamang sagot. C and D are eliminated. So A or B na lang ating pagpipilian. So sino po bang nagre-revoke at nagsususpend? So take note that suspension and revocation and also the issuance of your certificate of registration or licenses is under the authority and power of your Professional Regulatory Board of Nursing. So letter A. So BON po ang may karapatan na mag-issue, mag-suspend, mag-revoke ng certificate of registration or professional licenses. Hindi po si PRC, okay? So letter A is the correct answer here. Then next, question number 10. You were invited by the women's organization to be the resource speaker on the violence against women and children. So, women and their children are protected against violence under Republic Act number A, 9173, B, 9211, C, 9262, or letter D, 9160. So, dito, letter A is eliminated kasi that is the Nursing Act. Lalong-lalo na pong mali yung ating letter B, 9211, because that is the Tobacco Regulation Act. So, the correct answer here is letter C, the Republic Act 9262, or the VAWCI, or the Violence Against Women and Their Children. That is the Republic Act that protects the women and their children against any violence. So, RA 9262 is the Violence Against Women and Their Children Act of 2004, which refers to any act or series of acts committed by any person against a woman who is his wife, former wife, or against a woman with whom the person has or had a sexual or dating relationship, or with whom he has a common child, or against her child, whether legitimate or illegitimate, within or without the family abode, which result in or is likely to result in physical, sexual, psychological harm or suffering, or economic abuse, including threats of such acts, battery, assault, coercion, harassment, or arbitrary deprivation of liberty. So any violence against women and their children, it violates the Republic Act 9262. So the correct answer here is letter C. Oh, 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 oh